If you're taking notes, the title of my message is simply this: Lead Me to the Rock. Lead Me to the Rock. We're going to read from Psalm 61, verse 2, and then we're going to flip over to the New Testament and read from Matthew 7, verse 24 to 25. Psalm 61, verse 2, and I'm reading from the King James Version. It says, "From the end of the earth will I cry unto thee. When my heart is overwhelmed, lead me to the rock that is higher than I." And in Matthew 7, verse 24 to 25, it says this: "Anyone who listens to my teaching and follows it is wise, like a person who builds a house on solid rock. Though the rain comes in torrents and the flood waters rise and the winds beat against that house, it won't collapse because it is built on bedrock. When my heart is overwhelmed, lead me to the rock." Let's pray. Thank you, Jesus, that you're already in this place this morning. And we pray that you would come and you would fill every heart, fill every life. Holy Spirit, that you would come and inhabit this place today. Fill every lounge room, fill every heart that is watching today, this morning. We pray, God, that these words would not be my words, but your words through me. Breathe upon us afresh this morning. Amen. 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 I grew up in the Bay of Plenty. If you don't know the Bay of Plenty, it is a beautiful part of New Zealand, of Aotearoa. And I grew up in a small town called Te Puke. Now, it doesn't have a lot going for it, apart from that it is the kiwi fruit capital of the world. And it also is about 10 or 15 minutes drive away from Mount Maunganui Beach, which, in my opinion, very humble opinion, is one of the greatest beaches on the planet. I love the sand. I love the salt water. I love the waves. I love the beach. And I love just being in and around the water, boating, paddleboarding, kayaking. I know I don't look like, maybe a surf person, because I'm now in pasty white Cantabrian, but when I grew up, I looked more like I belong on the set of Home and Away. I was a surf girl. And surf labels were all I wore when I moved to Wellington. I was wearing Rip Curl and Billabong. I was ripping it hard. And all this to say, the beach is my happy place. And when it comes to being in and around the sea, I really back myself. I think I have what it takes. I know the sea. I know how to identify a rip, and I know how to save someone's life if they're drowning in the sea. And a few summers ago, we were on holiday in Kaiteriteri Beach in Christchurch. It is where Christchurch goes to summer. And so if you want to talk to everyone from your church in your togs, then you go to Kaiteriteri Beach. And we were on holiday there. It's up by Nelson, and me and my daughter, who was 9 years old at the time, we decided we would go for a kayak. We're going to go kayaking around the point from the bay where we are staying, and we're going to go around the point and meet the family at the beach and have a day at the beach, and then we would kayak back around the point. Seems easy, right? And I totally back myself when it comes to being in and around the water. We would meet the family there, we would spend the day there, and then we would kayak back. Ben had his doubts. My husband Ben, he had his doubts, but I reminded him my skill, my confidence in the water. I reassured him there was nothing to be worried about, that I have life jackets and I have surf life-saving skills and I have got this. On the way there, it was smooth, it was beautiful, it was calm, it was like the kayak was like a knife through warm butter. It was just beautiful. We arrived with no problem at all. And I said to Ben, "See, what were you worried about? No problem at all." And we spent a beautiful day at the beach, and then it was time to head home. And it was then that I noticed that the wind had picked up a little, and there were a few more waves, a few white caps there. And Ben asked, "Are you sure you're going to be okay?" And there was no other option, really. We can't carry the kayak over the hill. We can't put it in the car. We can't go over it. We can't go under it. We have to go through it. Plus, Ben, my skills. And one thing to note about this kayak is that technically it is a one-person kayak. And so with two of us, it definitely sat a little lower than it should, which in a moment you'll see why it's problematic. But regardless, we started our journey home. And I quickly realized this was a lot harder than the way there. The wind had definitely picked up. And whilst I was paddling with all of my strength, we were not going anywhere fast. In fact, there were moments I thought, perhaps we are going backwards. My strength was waning. My arms were burning. I was overwhelmed. And I was having doubts. Secretly, I was very afraid. There were fishermen who were fishing on the rocks and smiling and waving at us. And I smiled and waved back. And they had no idea of our struggles. My pride kept us going. I have to prove Ben wrong. I have to show everyone I have got this. And as we reached the point, and because we were sitting quite low, the waves started to come into the kayak. And so I said in my calmest manner to my 9-year-old daughter, "Lily, I don't think we're going to make it." To which she said, "What?" And so we made a plan. "Lily, if this kayak sinks, we will abandon ship. We will leave our belongings behind, and we will swim to the rocks, and we will swim to solid ground." All I could think of in that moment was, like Dory, just keep swimming, just keep paddling, just keep paddling. And slowly but surely, we rounded the point. We could see land. Our hopes were lifted, my strength regained, and finally, we made it to solid ground. And I can tell you, I have never been so glad to be on land. I think I kissed the ground. You know, we may laugh at this kind of situation, but I think it can be a picture of us in life sometimes. Maybe here, maybe watching online today. We're in the kayak of life, and things come against us. And in that moment, I wasn't thinking about dinner. I wasn't thinking about the plans for next week. All I could think about was just keep paddling. Not thinking about anything apart from just getting through this current challenge I am facing. And that can be us in life, right? Head down, arms spinning, doing everything in our own strength to turn the situation around. And we're going backwards and we're getting swamped. It can be hard for us to see beyond our current situation. Situations change. One moment, calm, smooth, not a breath of wind. And then suddenly, waves out of nowhere, a storm out of nowhere, overwhelming us. Maybe for you this morning, it's a doctor's report. Your health, it's always been good. But one report from the doctor, bam, storm out of nowhere. Maybe it's an email, a conversation, a job loss, a house sale that hasn't gone through, a relationship breakdown. Maybe for you, like our kayak, things are weighing you down. Worry, anxiety, the pain of the past, unforgiveness or hurt, situations that we are struggling just to let go of. Or maybe our foundation is shaky. You're sitting on those waves and it's shaking you. And we realize that I can't base my life on my financial success, my job, my career, my health, my own strength, my own pride, my influence, my relationships. And maybe from the outside looking in, no one would know. And like me, you're just paddling, waving to the fishermen on the rocks. Like things are all good, but on the inside, things are falling apart. And so when things come against us, when situations suddenly change, a storm comes from nowhere seeking to take us out, when we're weighed down and heavy, when we're desperately trying to build our lives on our own strength, when things look good on the outside, but they're falling apart on the inside, we look for firm ground. We look for a solid foundation. We find ourselves asking, what is certain? What is sure? What is stable? What is my foundation? I wonder what you're facing today that has got you overwhelmed. What wind and waves are coming against you? What is weighing down your boat? What was going smooth that has suddenly become a storm. Things can cause us in our lives in different seasons to be overwhelmed, to find it difficult to see any way out or see beyond what is right ahead of us right now. And we become uncertain of what the future holds. I know that's been the case in my own life many times, many seasons where I've felt overwhelmed, struggling to see beyond, weighed down with worry or guilt or shame, pretending like it's all okay when really it's not. And I know this is a message for me today. When we feel overwhelmed, for us here today in this building, for watching on those watching online, when we feel overwhelmed, where do we go? What do we lean upon? What is our life built upon? See, firstly, storms will come, and they will reveal what our lives are built on. Storms will come, and they reveal what our lives are built on. The truth is, storms will come. That is inevitable. You're going to face hardship, situations, things coming against you. In our opening passage, it says, when my heart is overwhelmed, lead me to the rock. It's not if my heart is overwhelmed, it's when. When my heart feels overwhelmed. Jesus said in John 16:33, in this world, you will have trouble. Storms will come. Storms will come. And the storm reveals who or what we will run to, what we rely upon, what we build our lives upon. You see, so often when things come against us, when storms come, we run from God. And we turn to things like addiction or scrolling social media or binge watching Netflix. We just want to escape the problem, right? We just want to ignore it. It's there, but I'm just going to sit over here and just pretend like it's not there. And we search for something to try and fill that gap that we feel. Or maybe we blame God for the storm. We get angry. We lash out at the people around us. We lose emotional control. We get stressed. We get sad. We get numb, letting it out on those closest to us. Or maybe we just try and do it in our own strength. Like me paddling with my pride keeping me going. We just try and figure it all out on our own. I don't need God. I just got to work harder. I've just got to study harder. I've got to Google the solution. I've got to worry my way out of this mess. Anyone else guilty of that one? That's me, for sure. But we soon realize we cannot build our life upon these things. We cannot do it in our own strength. We cannot figure it all out on our own because we were never designed to be those kind of people. We need to go to the rock. In our opening passage, it says, when my heart is overwhelmed, lead me to the rock that is higher than I. Who or what is that rock? Christ. Christ is the only sure thing we can build upon. He is our rock. Many verses throughout the Bible that speak of Jesus as our rock, our firm foundation. We sang it earlier this morning. Christ is our firm foundation. The solid rock we can depend on, build our lives upon. He is immovable. He is sure. He is certain. Psalm 18, verse 2 says this, the Lord is my rock, my fortress, and my Saviour. My God is my rock in whom I find protection. He is my shield, the power that saves me, and my place of safety. Colossians 2, verse 6, and now, just as you accepted Christ Jesus as your Lord, you must continue to follow him. Let your roots grow down into him and let your lives be built on him. Let your lives be built on him. We can also be certain that all those circumstances, situations, people, relationships, things around us may change. Jesus never does. Hebrews 13 verse 8, Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever. He doesn't change. He doesn't move. He doesn't let us down. He doesn't leave us. He doesn't forsake us. The one thing that undergirds all the rest of our life and existence is Jesus. He is our rock. He doesn't change. He is something we can build our lives upon with certainty. When my heart is overwhelmed, lead me to the rock. When things around me, life is overwhelming, out of control, hard, uncertain, come to Jesus. When we turn our eyes to Jesus, when our lives are built on Him, we can make it through the storm. Jesus is that higher than I. It says, lead me to the rock that is higher than I. Isaiah 55, verse 8 and 9. My thoughts are nothing like your thoughts, says the Lord. Amen. And my ways are far beyond anything you can imagine. For just as the heavens are higher than the earth, so my ways are higher than your ways, and my thoughts are higher than your thoughts. You know, like me in that kayak, I'm just head down, paddling. I'm just thinking about the situation, the thing right ahead of me. And when we're head down, paddling, struggling to see beyond, Jesus is able to give us a greater perspective, able to do more than we can imagine or perceive right now. When we come to Jesus, we can say, let me see what you see. Help me to see beyond what is currently overwhelming me. Help me to see a way through. Help me to have hope. Jesus, what is your heart? What are you saying to me through this? What are you doing in me before you can do it through me? The writer of this psalm in our opening passage, he understood David. He understood what it was like to walk through all kinds of situations that would overwhelm him. Heartbreak, loss, grief, attack. Yet he also understood the only thing he could build his life upon with certainty was Jesus, was God. Later on in the Psalms, he says this in Psalm 62, verses 5 to 8. Yes, my soul, find rest in God. My hope comes from Him. Truly He is my rock and salvation. He is my fortress, and I will not be shaken. My salvation and my honor depend on God. He is my mighty rock, my refuge. Trust in Him all times, you people. Pour out your hearts to Him, for God is our refuge. He is rest for our soul. He is our hope. He is our rock. He is our salvation. He is our fortress. He is our refuge. He is who we can trust at all times. And His name is Jesus. His name is Jesus. Build our lives upon the rock. Finally, the way to ensure a firm foundation is to hear the words of God and put them into practice. Matthew 7, 24, 25, we read it right at the start. It says, anyone who listens to my teaching and follows it is wise, like a person who builds a house on solid rock. Though the rain comes in torrents and the flood waters rise and the winds beat against that house, it won't collapse because it is built on bedrock. It's not just enough to hear the words of God, to come and listen to a message, but we need to put it into practice. To build upon the rock means to do the hard work of digging, of self-examination, of active faith in Jesus. The greater their foundation, the stronger and more sure the building. So how do I hear these words and not just hear them, but do them, put them into practice? And this is where it's a message for me this morning, but every morning when I wake up, maybe we're feeling anxious, worried about what is ahead for the day. Before anything else, lead me to the rock. Pray, seek God, ask for His wisdom over our lives. And the last thing before we go to bed, when there's so much consuming us, so many things to do, we're worried about what's going to happen tomorrow. Open the Word. Declare that psalm over our lives that says, I will lie down and I will sleep in peace. For you alone make me dwell in safety. Lead me to the rock. As you're driving in our cars and our mind is whirring, we're playing over and over again that situation or that email we just read. I could listen to talkback or whatever's on the radio, or I could choose, turn up that worship music, pray, pour out my heart to God, and say, lead me to the rock. The end of the day, this is for me, this one. The end of the day, when the kids are finally in bed, instead of sitting on the couch and scrolling social media, watching those reels, conviction, I'm going to open my Bible app and say, lead me to the rock. When we're gathered together on a Sunday with other Christians, maybe in a building or maybe watching online, instead of thinking about what's coming up this week and being distracted by all the things that are happening around us, would I choose to lift my hands in worship? Would I choose to lean into the Word? Would I choose to look to who I can encourage and say, lead me to the rock. Lead me to the rock. Let it be the way we start and finish every day. Jesus, I'm coming to you. I'm drawing closer to you. I want more of your presence. I want more of you. There is so much going on and consuming me, but I'm declaring that my life is built on Jesus. Lead me to the rock. As a band join me this morning, storms will come, and they reveal what our lives are built on. Christ is the only sure thing that we can build our lives upon. He is our rock. The way to ensure a firm foundation is to hear the words of God and put them into practice. There is so much noise, so much clamoring for our attention and for our response. But as for me, I will choose to pray. I will choose to worship. I will choose to seek God in His Word. I will choose to be led to the rock. I will choose to build my life on Jesus. He is sure. He is firm. He is certain, and He does not change. Come on, let's give Him praise this morning.